Good morning. A situation where Bernoulli's equation is applicable results in Torricelli's theorem. Though Torricelli's theorem is a special case of Bernoulli's equation, it was discovered almost a century before Bernoulli by Evangelista Torricelli, who was an Italian physicist and mathematician and a student of Galileo.
Flippin' physics.
The special case begins with a very large reservoir filled with an ideal fluid which is open to the atmosphere on top and has a small spigot near its bottom which is also open to the atmosphere. The equation which describes the speed of the fluid flowing out of the small spigot is Torricelli's theorem, which we can derive by starting with Bernoulli's equation. First, we identify the point 1 at the top of the fluid, the point 2 at the end of the spigot, and the horizontal zero line at the center of the spigot. Bobby, please give us Bernoulli's equation.
Okay. Pressure at point 1 plus 1 half times fluid density times the speed at point 1 squared plus fluid density times gravitational field strength times the vertical height of point 1 above the horizontal zero line equals, that's the same thing, only change all the 1 subscripts to 2s. That's Bernoulli's equation. How is that different from Bernoulli's principle again?
The equation is called Bernoulli's equation, and the relationship between fluid speed and fluid pressure is called Bernoulli's principle.
Yeah, right. Thanks.
You're welcome.
Right. Now, realize because both points 1 and 2 are open to the atmosphere, they are both equal to the atmospheric pressure and cancel one another out in the equation.
Hold up. The spigot is lower than the top of the reservoir, so the pressure is actually higher at the spigot, right?
Yeah.
The density of air is much, much smaller than the density of water, so that difference in height causes a very small pressure difference, which is negligible.
Sure. Okay.
Exactly, Billy. Thanks. And because cross-sectional area at point 1 is much, much larger than the cross-sectional area at point 2, we know this because the reservoir is described as very large and the spigot is described as small. We can assume the speed of the fluid at point 1 is approximately equal to 0. The level of the fluid in the reservoir does not significantly change as fluid flows out of the spigot. That means we can cross the term with speed at point 1 in it out of the equation. And let's identify the height of point 1 above the horizontal zero line as h1. And we know point 2 is at the horizontal zero line, so the vertical height of point 2 is 0. That means we can also cross out the term with vertical height at point 2 in it, out of the equation. All we are left with is fluid density times gravitational field strength times height 1 equals 1 half times fluid density times speed at point 2 squared.
And
everybody brought fluid density to the party.
Everybody brought mass.
And we can solve for speed at point 2. It equals the square root of 2 times gravitational field strength times height of point 1. That equation for the speed of an ideal fluid flowing out of a small spigot in a very large reservoir is Torricelli's theorem. Another important thing to notice is that if we were to drop a ball at point 1 and the ball were to freely fall straight down to point 2, we can use the fact that mechanical energy of the ball remains the same throughout this event to solve for the speed of the ball at point 2. We've identified points 1 and 2, so let's set the horizontal zero line at point 2 and identify the system as the ball and the Earth. We get mechanical energy at point 1 equals mechanical energy at point 2. The only type of mechanical energy our system has at point 1 is gravitational potential energy. Mass times gravitational field strength times vertical height above the horizontal zero line at point 1, which is h1. The only type of mechanical energy our system has at point 2 is kinetic energy, 1 half mass times speed at point 2 squared. And
everybody brought mass to the party.
Everybody brought mass.
And we get that the speed of the ball at point 2 equals the square root of 2 times gravitational field strength times height 1. It turns out that when the change in vertical heights is the same, the speed of the dropped ball is the same as the speed of the fluid flowing out of the spigot. Imagine discovering that roughly 400 years ago.
Ah, cool.
Whoa. That's, wow.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.